अस्सलाम वालेकुम, माय नेम इज सुमन अकरम। द टॉपिक ऑफ माय प्रेजेंटेशन इज प्रिजर्वेटिव्स ऑफ एनिमल्स, प्लांट्स एंड ह्यूमन ऑर्गन। दीज आर द कंटेंट्स, केमिकल यूज इन द प्रिजर्वेशन ऑफ एनिमल ऑर्गन्स, हाउ दीज केमिकल प्रिजर्व एनिमल ऑर्गन्स, केमिकल यूज इन द प्रिजर्वेशन ऑफ प्लांट ऑर्गन्स, हाउ दीज केमिकल प्रिजर्व प्लांट ऑर्गन्स, chemical used in the preservation of human organs, how these chemicals preserve human organs. Then I will tell you chemical used in the preservation of animal organs. The most common fixative is formaldehyde or a formaldehyde and water solution known as formalin. Some specimens may not be fixed before being submerged in the fluid preserve. The fluid preserve, the preserve is commonly alcohol, ether, ethanol, or isopropyl alcohol. How these chemicals preserve animal organs? Preparation of specimen is done by fixing it. It is done by injecting the specimen with a chemical that prevents the decaying process, also known as autolysis. The chemical that is mostly used in formaldehyde and water formaldehyde is dissolved in water is known as formalin, which is known as a preservative. The fluid preserve is commonly alcohol, ether, or ethanol. Then we will preserve it in a glass jar or bottle sealed with a closure. Type of closure may vary within a collection and often include lids and gas lids. Large specimens may require the use of open glass tank. Although the fixation and fluid preservation process caused a chemical alteration of the specimen and can lead to discolorization, shrinking, or swelling of the specimen, these collections are able to last a hundred of years. Staff members working with these collections are not generally at risk of chemical injury from the fluid unless a jar breaks. The greatest hazard of fluid preserved collection is a flammable nature of the chemical. A build up of fumes will increase the chances of fire. The most common animals to be preserved in fluid are aquatic invertebrates and entomology specimens may also be fluid preserved. Other materials may be stored in food such as plants and minerals. Storage jars should be mentioned for the determination of closure that would lead to the leakage of flammable chemical fumes into a storage area. Open containers will continuously leak fumes into environment, so the storage area should be ventilated. Then the following suggestions will help to prevent breakage of glass containers and the possibility of chemical spills, and will promote protection of specimens and museum staff in the storage areas. Storage shelves should be flat and level, probably with the lip on the edge, to keep containers from falling off and breaking. Do not overcover storage shelves. Then use flammable materials, signaling storage species, set up appropriate fire requirement. To protect from contact with formalin, if a container does break or drugs transportation of the specimen from one solvent to another, always wear personal protection equipment to protect cloth and body, such as disposable gloves, eye gloves, and when working with a large amount of solvent, a lab coat. Install an eye wash station in a storage area. Keep storage areas well ventilated. Keep formaldehyde split kits accessible. Institutions that reuse ethanol as the fluid preserve through an ethanol recovery system should follow guidelines set for handling of hazardous wastes. The Environmental Protection Agency website outline hazard waste regulation. The American Museum of Natural History recently completed the C.V. Starr Natural Science Building that housed the invertebrate zoology alcohol preserve collection in a 4,000 square foot compactor facility with an adjoining laboratory area. So more than 700 cases in the until allow for well organized and secure storage in an environment for the stable temperature and humidity. The museum equipped the storage area with several safety precautions that meet regulations set by the New York Fire Department, including sprinkler system, storage of material at least 1 foot away from the sprinkler head to allow uninterrupted water flow, supply of fire extinguishers that there are inspected annually by an outside source, 2 hours fire routed construction for the wall of storage areas, 1.5 hour fire routed construction for the donor of the storage areas, automatic door closes on all doors, the use of flammable storage refrigerators only for alcohol storage, no smoking signing posted inside and outside the storage area, hazardous materials signing posted outside the storage areas. Autumn leaves flawless, then I will define. Chemical used in the preservation of plants. Flowers and foliage are normally dried and subsequently treated for the preservation. Chemical drying involves use of borax, silica gel, detergent, and conamels, alum, or other composition available off the shelf. This is the ensure for retention of the natural shape and reduction in shrinking and cooler. It takes between 1 to 3 weeks for drying. The method of drying varies with different kinds of flowers. How these chemicals preserve animal organs. For the preservation of foliage, glycerin is added to high temperature water at 1:2 ratio while stripping. The stem are keeping in the solution between 2 to 6 weeks for a full absorption by the dried foliage. In another method, silica is used for coat that dried foliage by spraying, dipping, or brushing for preservation. One may use hairspray instead of a shellac. This use will be further finished by using plastic spray to prevent absorption for moisture. It is learned that glycerin method is widely used in herbarium, absorb the world, and some uses borax silica gel method. You may go through the book Preserving Flowers and Leaves by Francis Argon. Autumn leaves, flawless fronds, prickly glosses, and perfect petals are the great specimens to be noted and preserved. You can preserve, buy, or build a plant. Select your specimen, tag it in the field, and assigning it a number, record the number on the tag and in your field. General along the notes about where you found it, when, and any other observation that might help with identification. Bring the specimen back to the classroom either in a rigid container or a plastic bag. A moist paper towel in the container will help prevent the plant from wilting. If you take a plant, press along, you can process with the next step right in the field. To press the specimen, clean up the plant, brush off loose soil and blot of moisture. Arrange the plant on a sheet of newspaper next to it. Place the identification tag with its name, a number you have assigned to it, the location where it was collected, when it was collected, and by whom. Make sure the same information in your journal. Place another piece of newspaper on the top of plant. Then make layer, place a piece of newspaper with your specimen inside between two pieces of blotting papers, then between two pieces of corrugated. Then place the resulting package in plant, press and gently skew it down and also alternate. You can hold it securely together with straps or place some heavy objects on top. You can dry several plants in the press at one end. Each should be arranged in the same layer as described above. Check the plants every 2 or 3 days and replace the damp papers with dry ones. It will take from 2 or 4 weeks before the specimens are completely dry. Methods for plant preservation organs. There are few methods of preservation used in preserving plants and flowers. They are air drying, chemical drying, pickupping drying, face down drying, sand drying, pressing foliage and flower and drying and preserving with glycerine or shellac and finishing with plastic spray or by wax. Chemical used in the preservation of human organs. Formaldehyde changes the tissues on a molecular level so that the bacteria can't feed on the tissues. This is achieved by treating the cadaver with special chemicals. Embalming, one of the most important chemicals for this purpose, is formaldehyde. How chemicals preserve human organs. Modern embalming is one of the most effective and commonly used techniques for preserving dead bodies. After bodily fluids are drained and gases are released, the body is usually bathed in formaldehyde and alcohol or water. If done correctly, most bodies have shelf life of about 10 years. How to preserve organs? How some scientists initially preserve some organs. These are sterile component, washing solution, aromatic powder, aquat vita, radix rosary, and chamomile, blessing, mead, anthes, saliva, lavendula, and rorima, and marijuana, thema, absinthe, and cypri, and calamity, erotoma, and genetia, iroflorant, echovidreta, caryophyllid, and nusic monster, etc. Embalming powder used by Peter Forensic. Prepare a powder from 2 to 1/2 lbs aloes and 1.5 lbs mycine, 7 handful of ordinary balm, 4 handful of rosemary, 1 to 2 lbs pumice, 1 to 2 lbs marjoram, and 2 lot stories calamata, and 1 to 2 lot ziltimetha. Solution and powder used by W. Hunter. Artificial injection solution, emulsive solution, oil temperature, and compacted spirit of wines, add vaccine temperature, oil of antimula, oil of lavender, portion of valmint dye, powder washing solution, complex essential oil, and rosemary and lavender, and resin and nitrate. Gunnell's experimental arsenal, acid, acetic, then arsenic, nitric, and hydrophilic. Alkali salt of copper, mercury, alum, tannum, and creosote alcohol. Various combination, alum, sodium, chlorine, nitrate of potash, acetate of alum, chloride of alum. Then sepia solution, 1 part of glycerin. He used 1 part of glycerin, 1 part of solution of formalin, 40% saturated with zinc sulfate, and 10% of dry zinc chloride. 1 part of solution of alcohol saturated of salicylic acid. Okay, that's all about my topic. Thank you so much.